Welcome back to online classes. Children, in previous sessions we learned about model assessment sheet. Okay, so today we are going to revise whatever we have learned in previous classes. So today we will start with revision day 1, unit 7, division. So we have learned about division concept. Already you know what is division. So let us recall whatever we have learned. Okay, so what is division here? Division is a process.
Divides is called
and what is the dividend? 8. So after the division process, what remains? That is called as remainder. Okay. After division, what remains? That is called as remainder. So after the division process, what remains undivided? That is called as remainder. Got it?
Divided by 1 is equal to 35.
Happy 5,000 divided by 1 is equal to 1,000. 98 divided by 1 is equal to 98. 11 divided by 1 is equal to 11. So, what is the division property? Number 1, when a number is divided by 1, the quotient is number itself. Got it? So, these are few examples. Now, let's move to the second property of division. So, property number 2. Okay? So, here, property number 2. Let's see what it says. Property number 2. When a non-zero number divided by itself, comma, when a non-zero number divided by itself, the quotient is 1. So, when a non-zero number is divided by itself, the quotient is 1. For example, here we can take 10 divided by 10 is equal to 1. 35 divided by 35 is equal to 1. 18 divided by 18 is equal to 1. 100 divided by 100 is equal to 1. 1000 divided by 1000 is equal to 1. 25 divided by 25 is equal to 1. 30 divided by 30 is equal to 1. 5 divided by 5 is equal to 1. 16 divided by 16 is equal to 1. So, 70 divided by 70 is equal to 1. So, any number divided by itself, the quotient is 1. So, division property number 2. When a non-zero number is divided by itself, the quotient is 1. Got it? Now, next move to the third property. Property number 3. When 0 is divided by non-zero number, when 0 is divided by non-zero number, comma, the quotient is 0. The quotient is 0. So, when 0 is divided by a non-zero number, the quotient is 0. So, let's take few examples here. 0 divided by 9 is equal to 0. So, next. 0 divided by 10 is equal to 0. 0 divided by 100 is equal to 0. 0 divided by 1000 is equal to 0. 15 or 0 divided by 15 is equal to 0. 0 divided by 25 is equal to 0. 0. 0 divided by 11 is equal to 0. So when 0 is divided by a non-zero number, the quotient is 0. So children, it is the third property of division. So here we will take one more example. 0 divided by 18 is equal to 0. Got it? Now let's move to the property number 4. Okay, so when the remainder is 0, okay, then we find the quotient. When the remainder is 0, dividend, divisor and quotient are always factors of the dividend, or we can tell in short as the quotient and the divisor are the quotient and divisor are factors of the dividend. Okay, so when the remainder is 0, the quotient and the divisor are always factors of the dividend. You can add here one more word, always. Factors are always factors of the dividend. For example, here we can take 12 divided by 2. So 12 is a dividend, 2 is a divisor. So recall the table of 2. 2, 6 are 12. So 6 times 2 is equal to 12. So write 6 above, 12 under the dividend, then subtract. 2 minus 2, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. Now observe here children, 2 is a divisor into quotient 6. So 6 2's are 12, or else 2 6 are 12. Okay, so here the divisor and quotient are the factors of the dividend. So it is multiplication and days. You have learned in previous chapter. So 6 is first factor, 2 is second factor. So 12 is product. So this product is quotient here in division problem. So when the remainder is 0, the quotient and the divisor are always factors of the dividend. We can take here one more example as 18 divided by 2. So 2 9's are 18. Okay, 8 minus 8 0, 1 minus 1 0. So here 2 is the divisor, 9 is the quotient. So 9 2's are 18, or else 2 9's are 18. So 2 and 9 are factors of the dividend 18. Got it? So these are the four properties of division which you have to learn. Okay? If you are able to recall these properties, you can solve the problems based on properties. Okay? So they can ask you the questions, multiple choice questions based on division properties. Now let's practice to find the quotient. Okay? Find the quotient. divided by 4. So when we have to find the question, we have to follow 5 steps. So let us recall those steps. Step 1. Divisor. Step 2. Multiply. So here you have to multiply the divisor into dividend. Okay? You should multiply these numbers together. Step 3. Divide. So you have to divide the given dividend using the divisor. Step 4. Subtract. So you have to subtract the product from the dividend. Step 5. Bring down. So if any digit remains in ones column or in tens column, you should bring down. So by following these 5 simple steps, we can solve any division problem. So now 24 divided by 4. So first we compare. In 4 on the table, 24 is there. Certainly my answer is correct. Is there. So how many times 4 is equal to 24? Or 24, how many times goes into 4? So here 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12, 4 fours are 16, 4 fives are 20, 4 six are 24. So how many times? 6 times. So write 6 above in one column, the product under the dividend 24, then subtract. 4 minus 4, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. So here 24 divided by 4 is equal to 6. The quotient is 6. The remainder is 0. So remember children, when the remainder is 0, we call it as exact division. When the remainder is 0, we call it exact division. Got it? So when the remainder is 0, we have to call it as exact division. Got it? Now one more example. 19 divided by 2. So compare the given numbers. In 2 ones are table, 19 is there? No. So we have to take equal to 19 or less than 19. Then only we can subtract. Okay? So recall the table of 2. So 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6, 2 fours are 8, 2 fives are 10, 2 sixes are 12, 2 sevens are 14, 2 eights are 16. 2 nines are 18. So write 9 above, 18 under the dividend, then subtract. 9 minus 8, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. So here, 9 is the quotient, remainder is 1. So here 1 left undivided. So it is called as remainder. Got it? So it is division with remainder. Division with remainder. Have you got it, children? When the remainder is less than divisor, you should understand your division process is over. Okay? If the remainder is greater than divisor, you In one column we have 6. So bring down and write in one column. Now again repeat 5 steps. Compare 6 divided by 3. So in 3 mens on table 6 is there? S. So how many times 3 is equal to 6? 2 times. So 3 mens are 3, 3 twos are 6. So write 2 above in one column the product 6 under the dividend. Then you can subtract 6 minus 6, 0. So 0 below there is no number, so you can write 0 as it is. So what is the remainder here? 0. So it means that our division process is over. When we get the remainder less than divisor, we should understand our division process is over. Got it? So here 96 divided by 3 is equal to 32 is the quotient. Remainder is 0. So when you find the quotient, be sure that the product of a divisor should be less than dividend. Then only you can subtract. Okay? When you subtract, be sure that the remainder should be less than divisor. Got it? Now, shall we take one more example here? Now, let's take one more example. 93 divided by 2. So, what is the dividend here? 93 divisor 2. So we have to recall the table of 2. So in 2 on the table, 93 is not there. So we have to divide by a single digit. So in 10's column we have 9. 9 divided by 2. So recall the table of 2. In 2 on the table 9 is there? No. So we have to take nearest to 9. What is there in the table of 2? So in 2 on the table we have 8. So how many times 2 is equal to 8? 4 times. So write 4 above in 10's column. The product under the dividend 9. Then you can subtract 9 minus 8. 1. Okay. So next, bring down the next digit down. Write in 1's column. Now again you can repeat the 5 steps. Compare, multiply, divide, subtract, bring down. So here 13 divided by 2. So in 2 on the table 13 is there? No. So what we have to do? We have to take nearest to 13 or less than 13. So 2, 6 are 12. So write 6 above 12 under the dividend. Then subtract 3 minus 2, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. So here 93 divided by 2 is equal to 46 is the quotient. Remainder is 1. So here our remainder is less than divisor. So it means that our division process is over. Have you got it? Now look at the next one. One more example. 5 divided by or 48 divided by 5. So here we will take 48 dividend 5 as a divisor. So recall the table of 5. So in 5 as a table 48 is not there. So if we divide by a single digit, so 4 divided by 5. So in 5 on the table 4 is not there. So we have to take corresponding number here 0. 5 zeros are 0. So write above 0 in 10's column under the dividend 4 0. Then you can subtract 4 minus 0 4. Next is it. Bring down. Write in 1's column 48 divided by 5. So you can again recall the table of 5. In 5 on the table 48 is not there. 0. So if you solve like this also, it is correct. Okay, if you want to show the steps one by one, you can divide by a single digit also. Okay, have you got it? I hope you are following it. So have you got it, children? How to find the quotient? Now, so here we have taken number of problems to recall the division concept. Okay, so children, it's time to end our today's class. Remaining things we will learn in our next class. So what you have to do is, you have to read and learn the division properties and division terms. Okay, so in next class we will solve model assessment sheet based on division. Okay, so you should be read and you should practice division concept. Okay, so you can read and write same